time to go out and pick up a tan ready. All right, here we are, episode 6 to the Road to the Natty Mr. Australia series, sponsored by the MPT Natty Gains Academy. Today we are 4 and 6 weeks out from the comps. My current macros at the moment is 220 protein, 105 carbs, and 51 fats. So you'll notice each week my calories decline, right? As we go into phase 2, as I call it inside of our academy, which is revealing the masterpiece, aka dieting down for a comp, you pretty much just continue to drain the swamp, steal your calories, and actually increase output as well. So I'm actually doing 60 minutes of LIIS cardio, which is low intensity, steady state cardio. So for me, I do 4 15-minute walks at different times throughout the day. I'll do 15 minutes after breakfast. I'll do 15 minutes after post-workout. I'll do 15 or 30 minutes towards the end of the day. For me, I find that it's less mentally draining than doing 60 minutes of fasted cardio, like all of your IFBB pro bros do. Or even trying to do 60 minutes on the Stairmaster like the fit chicks do post-workout. I find both of those, and I've tried them before, not so much the steppers, post-workout, but I've tried the faster cardio, or I've tried 60 minutes in one block, and it just becomes too much effort. It puts you in a catabolic state, which is muscle wasting, whereas spreading those walks out throughout the day, now that I have the luxury of doing that, working from home, it doesn't make it daunting. I put the headphones on, I listen to an audio book, that G's me up or is teaching me about a topic that I'm interested in at the time, and it becomes very easy. It's not a chore. So that's my update with where we're at. Today's episode, I want to do a deep dive into what I eat and why I eat that, and also the supplement stack that I use year long, and also that I start to add in leading into a show. So first things first, I'll go through all of my nutrition, and this is stuff that I kind of use as a system for all of my clients as well. So I guess the main things that I'm eating for protein at the moment, I'll start with protein, is your grass-fed steak. I'm very lucky that I've got a butcher that I can get grass-fed eye fillet for, what do we got here, $23 a kilo. Insane. Okay, big tip for you guys, if you don't have this particular butcher, which is the super butcher up here on the Gold Coast, Aldi. Aldi do a eye fillet grass-fed steak for about $28 a kilo, which just shits all over Rump and Porterhouse. Okay, so that's my main protein source. I'm doing 200 grams 3 times a day. So I also get a lot of fats from my steak as well. The reason I like steak, it's packed full of iron, B vitamins, omegas, B6, I already said B vitamins, creatine, carnitine, CLA. It's almost a multivitamin and a protein source, if that makes sense. Of course, I've got your skinless, free-range chicken breast. This, I do one meal a day on top of my 3 servings of steak. I prefer steak to chicken because of all the extra bang for the buck that you get with your micronutrients. The other protein source I'll use is a full fat milk. I like this for its calcium, obviously it's a casein protein, and there's some good vitamins in the fats. And lastly, I'll use like a WPI, whey protein isolate to kind of bridge that protein gap. I usually have one post-workout and sometimes in my brekkie, depending on the day and how many carbs I've got for that given day as well. So that's my protein options. I actually left one out. One of them is eggs. So again, free range, high fat, there's a lot of vitamins and minerals inside the egg yolk. So I have 1 or 2 eggs a day as well. You know, as my calories get lower and lower, obviously the amount that I'm having is smaller and smaller, but I try to include at least one egg in my meal plan each day as well. Okay, so that's protein. Now carbs at 105 grams, you don't have many carbs to play with. 105 grams, if you've ever tried to track that, you'll realize how freaking low that is and how quickly that gets taken up. So a few strategies that I use, I'll get into the non-negotiables first. So there's a few things that I will always have, and I build my carbs outside of them. So number one is a kiwi fruit. It's basically one of the only superfoods or superfruits available. It's got folate in it, it's got more vitamin C than an orange, tons of vitamins and minerals in it, and it's actually a low bloat fiber as well. So I'll always have 80 grams of kiwi each day, so there's 15 grams of carbs gone already. I'll always do a raw carrot, anywhere from 50 to 60 grams. Again, it's a really good fiber source, awesome fiber source. And it's actually a hormone optimizer as well. And then 100 ml of cranberry juice. So we spoke about this goes in my pre-workouts, high in iodine, which most people are deficient in, and a ton of antioxidants as well. So now that those three are in, I'm probably sitting at 40 grams of carbs already, and I've got 65 grams of carbs for the entire day left. So this deep into a diet or into a phase two, revealing the masterpiece, you start to look for cheats and hacks. And one of those is Spud Light potatoes. I'm sure a lot of you guys have seen these before. These have 25% less carbs than a regular potato. So I'll be able to have probably 200 of these twice a day, 200 grams of these, not 200 of them, 200 grams, along with my steak or chicken, and it just makes the bowl or the container bigger. So I'm more satiated, I don't feel like I'm eating less, even though I am calorically. It just helps with gut fill. So that's one hack, and if you like the crispy, bready, salada or biscuit type things, which a lot of people like the crunch and they like that sodium and they like that kind of feeling, I'm doing two of these a day as well. So these are just a light crust kit. You know, 44 calories per crust kit. I think it's about 5 or 6 grams. I'm not sure, my fitness pal tells me all this stuff. There you go, yeah, 4.5 grams per crust kit. So I'll do steak on these as well. So that's pretty much it for nutrition. The other thing I wanted to mention too that I teach all of my clients to do inside our academy is to start the day with pink Himalayan salt. There's 84 trace minerals in here and it helps with hydrating your first thing, along with lemon, freshly squeezed lemon in room temperature water. We call that our shot of secret sauce, and it basically just flushes out the body and it balances your pH and it helps you with the most important thing for somebody that's trying to maintain supernatural levels of muscle, which is hydration. Okay, the muscle cell holds water, and if your hydration is affected, it's pretty obvious that your performance, your results, and therefore your gains are gonna be affected as well. So that's the nutrition side of things done, and now I'm gonna move into supps. Okay, so moving on to the supplements that I use coming into comp prep and that I use long-term. So I've thought about this long and hard all day, and I wanted to break it into sections. So to my left is my health stack. Most of these products I've been using for the last 8 years, with general health, digestive health, and gut health as the main focus. These three here, which is your omegas, your joint formula, and a multivitamin, I've probably included in the last 4 years. Especially when you're dieting, you can't get as many micronutrient-dense foods in, so it's also good to supplement with a multivitamin. That's not usually my multi, I'll go into that later. To my left, health. To my right here is more of a performance or a pre-workout, so I'm taking this stuff before I train. And then over here is hormone health and optimized recovery. So let's start with the general health stuff. So these three here, I'm usually using Core Multi, but my distributor, Massive Joe's, is actually out of Core Multi. Core Nutritionals is run by Doug Miller, who is a fellow natty bodybuilder, probably the best in history, I think. Very close anyway, there's lots of debates, but if you look at his physique, I think he's the best. And he basically, like me, was an online coach, developed a supplement company for himself and grew and expanded that, and now does that full time. So it's his brand. I use omega pills basically to get my fish oil in and my good fats, DHA, EPA, etc. I use this product here, which is called Flex. Now this is phenomenal. So, you know, being someone who's trained in the gym for 20 years, joint health is huge, you know, and I did pro wrestling for probably 8 years. So you've got to look after your joints. This has glucosamine, it's got MSM in it, it's got chondroitin, it's got black pepper extract in it, black cherry, it's got bromelain, it's got turmeric. It is probably the most complete joint formula that I've ever seen. They used to have it in powder, which I preferred, but it's in caps now, which is fine. So I take that every day. And then lastly is the multivitamin. At the moment, I'm using Andy Frisella's first form M factor for men, only because Core Nutritionals Multi isn't in stock in Australia at the moment. This is still quite good. This is probably my second choice. So this is my health stack here, moving into my digestive and alkaline health stack. So this is by a company called YOR HEALTH. It's American owned. They distribute here in Australia. This is a digestive enzyme. I eat steak 3 times a day, as you found out earlier. Now, some people will say doing that is not good for the gut. It's too hard to digest. Well, guess what? I've got a counter for that. I take a digestive enzyme. It's plant-based. It's got your bromelain in it. It's got the lactose enzyme. It's got the enzyme that breaks down fat. So I take that with every steak meal. I take that 3 times a day with my steak to help digest that. I've got a fiber blend. This is a fiber blend from 8 different products. So a lot of people will take fiber supplements and it doesn't work for them because it's one strain. This is 8 strains, okay? This is from banana peel. It's got chicory root, apple, and a bunch of other stuff. So it's a fiber blend with some omegas in it. And this is our super greens. This has the antioxidant equivalent of 24 servings of fruit and veg. It's got turmeric in it. It's got probiotic, a prebiotic. It's got CoQ10 enzyme in it as well. So I've been using this product every day. I start my day with this. Since 2013. So as bodybuilders, what we eat is largely acidic food. You look at the meats, the processed carbs, dairy, Most of the saps are kind of acidic forming. So typically you would, to try and alkalize that, you would go and get celery, you would get spirulina, you'd get wheatgrass, you'd get all these different organic greens from an organic fruit market, which I don't know about you, but I can't be effed doing that. So I'd rather take a scoop of this. It's in powder form. It's awesome stuff. I take it every morning just to make sure that I am alkaline, even though I'm eating like a bro and I'm eating like a bodybuilder. So that's a must. And then this one is a probiotic. Again, just optimizing gut health. They do say that 80% of your health and immunity is found in the gut. So I'm doing all of this to make sure that I'm looking after myself from a holistic standpoint. So that's my health stack. Okay, and I run that year long, whether I'm competing or not. That is the foundation, if you will. So from there, we talk about performance. I've been through this stuff. This is Pump. This is a non-stim product. Again, it's from Doug Miller. You got your Pico 2 mushroom extract in it, your citrulline malate, your beta alanine. There are a couple of patent ingredients in here as well. Hydromax, Alpha GPC for a bit of mental stimulus and brain function. That's been awesome. I quite like that. And leading into a contest, I obviously do need some caffeine and some mental focus and a little bit of a thermogenic effect, and that's where I choose to use his fat burning product. So this is called Burn. There's like 8 different variations of caffeine in here. It's got yerba mate. You've also got the KSM66, which is the ashwagandha extract, which is amazing for keeping your cortisol levels down, which is your stress hormone. Your stress hormone is usually aggravated by traffic, by the business stress, by what's going on with the media at the moment, but also by being in a calorie deficit. You know, being in a calorie deficit for a long period of time does make things seem bigger than they are, and it does make you a lot more stressed than what you are. Calorie deficit for a couple of weeks to lose a couple of kilos is easy. Anyone can do it. But the definition I like to use is it's almost like that ancient Japanese torture. You know, like if you were to, which is the water dripping on the forehead. You know, I could lay there and have water drip on my forehead for an hour, but talk to me after a week of the same drip, after a month, after 6 months. It just wears on you. And it's the same with the calorie deficit, which spikes your cortisol, which makes you hold on to water. It makes you lose your hormones much faster, and obviously highlights estrogen and brings down testosterone, which gives you a soft look, all right? So not good. So that KSM66 is awesome. It's got your carnitine in it as well, and it's got your Garcinia Cambogia too. So awesome fat product. These two go together for performance. I'll use them on and off throughout the off season. Off season, I'm not so big on stim. Pump formula, yes, I'll buy some citrulline malate or some beta alanine, you know, by themselves and just kind of mix that with whatever. But coming into a contest or a phase two, which is revealing the masterpiece, dieting down for a holiday or summer or whatever it may be, I do stick these two together. So that's performance. And then these four over here is more recovery and hormone optimization. So I've spoken about HARD before on this channel. I'm going to leave a link for a lot of these saps. Because I'm not a supplement specialist, but this HARD product is designed to bring your cortisol levels down, and it's designed to make you feel good and let off those feel-good endorphins, which, again, when you're dieting and stressed out and you've got a comp and you're trying to pose, you know, posing practice and all that kind of stuff, it's amazing. It's really good for people that run a tight ship and that run businesses or have stressful professions. Amazing product. I'm going to leave a link for that. So that is a must for any comp prep, probably 8 weeks out onwards. Okay, you are meant to cycle it for 12 weeks and then have a month off. A phenomenal product. So I'll stack that with Core Test. Again, this is like an anti-estrogen slash pro testosterone boosting product. A few different extracts. It's got your D-aspartic acid in it. There's a couple of different herb-based supplements in here as well, with another big dose of the KSM66 to be able to bring those stress levels down. So I'll actually take that in my pre. So these three will go in the pre. This one I have 3 times throughout the day: morning, afternoon, and before bed. And those, you know, these two combined just make sure that I'm optimizing my natural testosterone levels for as long as I can, even though I'm starving myself, stress is getting high, the workouts are getting hard, I'm doing all the cardio, the posing practice, etc. Absolute game changer. I'm telling you now, I've done 5 comps now, I think. This is gonna be my 6th, and I only use these for the last one. Huge difference, massive, massive difference on mood, energy, intensity in training in the gym. So awesome stuff. And these last two, this one here is, it's not secret, it's just creatine. Okay, I just get this from Bulk Nutrients, cheapest chips, $20 a kilo. Creatine monohydrate, 5 grams a day. I'll either have it pre-workout or I generally run it year long in with my super greens. And this one here is called Corebolic. So this has your laxagenin in it. Laxagenin is meant to be good for strength increase. And again, favoriting testosterone production, natural testosterone production, and keeping as much muscle as you can. A few good studies on that, so I thought, why not? And the other ingredient that I love that's in this is the Pico 2 extract. So I'm getting Pico 2 extract pre-workout in the pump, which is for your performance and helping you with power output. And then I have this later on in the afternoon, and I find that the Pico 2 extract, by having double servings of it, is helping me with hunger. Okay, so Pico 2 is actually an appetite suppressant. Pico 2 extract, by the way, is the, it's the mushroom blend. It's the turkey tail, the lion's mane, what else do they call it in here? Shiitake, the king trumpet. It's like the five or six mushrooms that everybody loves at the moment. You put them together, it's called Pico 2. And it's a great appetite suppressant. So I find that my food cravings are only just starting to kick in now, you know, 4 weeks out, which is awesome. You know, fighting food cravings for 4 weeks versus fighting it for four freaking months is a big difference. So very grateful for that sup. So that's it. That's my supplement stack. As I said, there's a health foundation, then there's performance, and then there's obviously optimizing hormones and recovery. Now, another thing I want to touch base on just before we finish up on the episode, inside our academy, we teach the concept of breaking down, you know, getting to stage or building your dream physique, whatever that end goal is. It doesn't have to be stage. It could just be photo shoot ready or wedding ready or holiday ready, or it's time to go out and pick up a tan ready or whatever it may be. You've got to break it down into two phases. You've got to do phase one, which is building the foundation. It's building enough muscle mass. It's getting your calories up high enough. It's bringing your stress down, focusing on sleep, getting good hydration and getting into a rhythm and having enough size, enough muscle size as a natural to then be able to go into phase two and reveal the masterpiece, as I call it, which is diet down, shred down, chisel down, and reveal all the muscle and gains that you've put on in phase one. One of the biggest problems I see with people that I work with who have had other coaches, or maybe they've tried to do it on their own through YouTube or TikTok or Instagram mentoring, whatever it may be, is they haven't done phase one. They haven't built their foundation. They haven't got their sleeping schedule right. They haven't built enough muscle mass as a natty to be able to do a cut. And what happens is their caloric intake is not big enough, their foundation is not strong enough, and by the time they get halfway down to revealing the masterpiece, they crash because they don't have enough calories in the bank and they don't have a big enough foundation set. So if you are going to get on stage and you are going to try to peak for a photo shoot or for a wedding or for whatever it may be, over here, revealing the masterpiece, you know, having the six-pack, the flat stomach, the broad chest, the V-taper, you've got to do a phase one first. And you've got to be able to build that foundation, get your metabolism right, get your sleep right, get your thinking right, your habits right, and then you can slowly go into a phase two. And in my experience, the longer that phase two is, you know, 12, 16 weeks is a minimum, 20 to 24 is ideal, the better it is, because the more muscle mass you'll hang on to, the more diet breaks you can schedule throughout the process, and the longer time you've got, the less stressful, especially with some of these sups, the process can be, and you can arrive on stage, you can arrive on the holiday, you can arrive at the wedding, you can arrive at Christmas Day and New Year's, whatever it may be, you know, happy, healthy, and in the best shape of your life. So I just wanted to share that before we conclude. This has been episode 6 on the road to the Natty Mr. Australia, sponsored by the MPT Natty Gains Academy. If you do want to apply for one-on-one coaching, there's a link below. We're taking on probably another 30 people for the rest of the year, another 30 clients for the rest of the year. So if you want to be one of them, you can apply there. There's also a 10% code for any of our MPT armory and merch. And I've left all the links for all these supplements where you can get them at a discounted rate as well. So that's it. Until next time, stay natty.